This is the 8th generation of Apple's iPad, released about 2 months ago along with the iPad Air 4 at Apple's September event. At a starting price of $329 or $429 here in Canada, it's Apple's cheapest tablet, but I also think that it has the best value for some users. And today I'll be talking about why it's been my main tablet used for school as a university student and some of the things I like and dislike about it. To start out, I have the 32GB model iPad in silver with the first generation Apple Pencil. I also have a matte screen protector on to make the writing feel a bit more texturized and similar to writing on paper. It improves the overall experience of writing on the iPad a lot compared with the regular glossy screen, and you can really feel a difference if you try one out, but I think you can also hear a difference when you're writing with it here. Just to give you guys my thoughts up front, I think this iPad is the best value pick from Apple's current line of tablets and is a really solid choice for a lot of casual users as well as students. However, there are some limitations given its low price point, so be sure to keep watching for more of my thoughts. The first thing is you'll be getting the full iPad experience along with most of the features from the more expensive iPad Air and iPad Pro, which means iPadOS 14 and support for the Apple Pencil, smart keyboard, and everything you expect from the Apple ecosystem. The Apple Pencil is a must-buy if you're using the iPad as a student, or if you're using it for anything beyond just watching videos and maybe some social media. I personally use the iPad and Apple Pencil for all of my class notes now, and I've even written a few virtual exams this year with the iPad on Microsoft OneNote. Speaking of OneNote, it's my favorite note-taking app, and I've been using it since my first year of university. It's incredibly simple to keep your notes organized in pages, sections, and notebooks within the app, and you can easily export PowerPoint or PDF slides to write on them directly within the app, and everything syncs onto OneDrive, so storage or cross-platform usage is never an issue. The design of the iPad hasn't changed since last year, so it might feel a bit dated to some users with the larger bezels, but honestly I haven't noticed it since I never owned an iPad Pro before, so it still does feel really solid and is super light and thin for day-to-day use as a student. The 10.2-inch display is bright and the colors are vibrant, but I do have a matte screen protector on, so it makes the display a bit less clear and bright as it usually would be. The only thing you're missing out on here is the fuller screen display from the iPad Air and Pro models, and the 120Hz refresh rate on the new iPad Pro, but again, if you haven't used it before, then you won't notice the difference. Finally, there are speakers only on the bottom, and they aren't the best, but they work, and I personally never consume media or music on my iPad without AirPods, headphones or an external speaker, so that hasn't really been an issue for me. Moving on to the performance, the iPad is really snappy with the new A12 Bionic chip and definitely enough to handle almost anything you'll need to do as a student or casual user. I haven't had any performance issue with this, whether I'm using it for work, school, or some light gaming. I even tried to run a few heavier games on this iPad and it seems to have held up really well and maintained a high frame rate throughout. But for students who need to run more demanding tasks like coding or 4K video editing, I wouldn't recommend getting this iPad if it's the only device that you're going to be using. You're better off using another device such as a laptop or a desktop for more versatility. But I personally don't use the iPad as my only device. I have a laptop mainly for school and I'm also building a desktop right now. So that said, I don't think most students are looking for this iPad to replace all of their devices and be the only one they use. An iPad Pro would be better suited for that role. I think this iPad does a really good job as a secondary or additional device that you can use for a lot of school and productivity tasks, but also for things like watching Netflix or casual gaming. The battery life of this is also amazing. I usually charge my iPad once every 2 or 3 days when I'm only using it for schoolwork, but even if you're gaming or watching movies on it, it should last you at least a full day. And lastly, just some other things that I wanted to touch on for this iPad. There is a 7-megapixel back camera, which isn't amazing, but honestly nobody's buying this iPad to go around taking photos with. This is the video and microphone quality of the iPad. It's not the greatest, but it works in decent lighting. The front camera isn't much better, but I honestly think it's better than the one on my $1,700 laptop that I use for school and work, so this should do you just fine if you need to use it for Zoom calls and classes. The iPad 8 also still uses lightning to charge, unfortunately, unlike the new iPad Pro and iPad Air, which have switched to USB-C. you are missing out on some functionality in terms of being able to connect with external hard drives and monitors. But again, that doesn't really matter for someone who isn't using this as their main device or their only device. The last thing to note is you're limited to two storage options, 32 gigabyte model, which is what I have, or the 128 gigabyte model for, I think, $100 more. If you're not storing too many photos or videos on this device, then the 32 gigabyte should be just fine, since the 128 is going to bring you closer to the price of the iPad Air 4. I hope this video was helpful to you. It was my first time doing tech and student-related content, so if you'd like to see more, drop a like and subscribe, and let me know down below in the comments if you have any feedback.